Hello, everybody. Today we're going to talk about what the Bible says about teaching your kids. Now, I've covered this before, I believe, and I'm not going to say anything too much different, but I was watching this video here about how school makes you dumb, and this guy, thoughty too, goes over how the best way to teach children and why most schools don't implement that way, right? And that way mainly being individual attention and interest. All right, so when you're a kid, everything's interesting. You're learning nonstop. You have to learn, you know, you have to learn about everything. You've never seen any of this before, so it's all new. So as you grow in your mastery of the world around you, typically you'll hone in on two things, maybe one to two things that you're mainly interested in, and you'll start to learn there. Well, in his video where he talks about how individual attention and learning this person as they're learning the way that they go is exactly what the Bible says, okay? So the Bible, twice in Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 6, 6 through 9 says, "And these words I command you today shall be on your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children, talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise. Okay, you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates." Okay, so in Deuteronomy 6, 6 through 9, you're constantly teaching your kid about the law of God, because that is the best way that we learn, is through individual teaching, okay? Now, you as a parent, as you're teaching your child, are going to learn how to teach them. You're going to learn their attention span, you're going to learn what they respond to the best and all this stuff. So that's why they learn as well as they do. If learning one of the most important things in the world is by doing it this way, then learning the things that may not be, that just aren't as important, is the same. You just use the same way. So Deuteronomy 11, 19, "Teach your children, talk to them when you're sitting in your house, when you're walking by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise." So you're always teaching your kids, always. There's never a time where you don't teach them. And I've seen the differences in children where the parents don't do anything with them when they get home. All they have is school, versus the kids who the parents are always teaching them something. They're always doing something with them. They're always learning something new on top of school, or maybe they're homeschooled. A lot of these kids who are homeschooled or have parental involvement after school do a lot better in life than kids who don't have that involvement. Titus 2, 4 through 5. "So train the young women to love their husbands and children, to be self-controlled, pure, working at home, kind and submissive to their own husbands, that the word of God may not be reviled." So this is again teaching women how to be good women, right? What does a woman of God need to do? And it goes through it, right? "Love their husbands and children, be self-controlled, pure, working at home, kind." The way that you teach that the best is by pairing up with someone and seeing how they do it. Okay, that has been recorded in all kinds of different learning, documentaries. I know I watched one where between 2 and 4, your kid is watching you, listening to you, and everything else to learn home patterns. So the way that they are going to live after they leave you, they're learning that in between there. After about there, they've already learned what they're going to learn. And a lot of that is set. You can relearn it later yourself, but a lot of that is set there. So for me, this is Bible in action. You can see it being played out here, where every time we talk about what's the best way to educate our kids, individually learning them, etc. So I hope you guys had a good day. That's all I'm going to say here. I just thought it was interesting. Don't forget today to pray and read your Bible, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, guys.